Kia ora. Well, it's been a very active week in Parliament buildings for me as one of the new recruits. We have been inducted by the Parliamentary Services people, introduced, I suppose, to some of the intricacies of the running of select committees. The Legislative Advisory Group was a highlight, a presentation by Sir Geoffrey Palmer, who set up that committee about 25 years ago. It truly has been a very informative and action-packed few days, coming to grips with the more arcane aspects of parliamentary life. Of course, next Tuesday, the House sits properly and we will have our first select committee meetings. On my one, which is Finance and Expenditure, a number of annual reports are going to be presented to us and I'm sure business will be getting underway. The reading for the first committee meeting is about that high, so it's going to be a very active weekend. Similarly, for Local Government and Environment, the select committee that I'm on meets on Thursday morning, so there's a lot to read in and a lot of contentious bills, which I'm sure will have local application on the North Shore. So I will be consulting widely on some of the aspects of the bills and the readings that come to us at Select Committee on those. More on that perhaps in my next video blog. Of course, it is coming up to Waitangi weekend, along with the Prime Minister and about 21 other members of the National Caucus. I will be going to Waitangi. It's promising to be a very lively affair this year. It always is, really. I've covered it many times across the media for radio and television news, and this is the first time I'll be part of the official gathering. I'm very much looking forward to that commemoration and to coming to Government House in Wellington, where the Governor-General is hosting a reception on the Monday afternoon. It is a busy week for me. Next Thursday, the 9th, between 4 and 6, I will be giving my maiden speech in the House, and I will post details on my Facebook and website about the actual time of that. If you would like to see it live, it is available on Parliament Television. And I will be, of course, referring to aspects of my notices around the North Shore, the sort of achievements that I would like to be a part of over the next 3 years or so. And it will be pretty much a statement of my intent as a politician. So quite a bit of reading and writing to be doing over the next few days in preparation for the all-important maiden speech on Thursday. It is also, of course, a lively time in the electorate. In my absence, I note that the 470 Junior World Sailing Championships, I was at the opening of them last Friday. They're going very well indeed. We have young Jack O'Gill competing against Valerie Adams on Saturday at the International Track Meet in Christchurch, and we wish him all the very best for that. And our congratulations to a North Shore designer who has been featured in the Hong Kong World of Wearable Arts, and that is to a designer by the name of Judith Keith, and she's from Campbell's Bay. Her entry is called Tiki Touring. Congratulations to her for putting the North Shore and its talent showcasing it on the world stage.